Hello everyone, today I am making a video on the diagrams actually, because there were many requests and many of the kids, as like whenever you have a class or something, they're like, they don't know how to make a diagram or what are the important diagrams which should be learnt and how to make those diagrams in the paper so that they may get full marks. So I'll be starting up chapter wise. I'll be making different videos for different chapters. Now we'll be starting up with the first we'll start up with the chapter photosynthesis. Now in the chapter photosynthesis we have multiple questions from the chapter, but the structural questions also, they are from the experiments. But there are two diagrams which are important from this chapter, which can come for drawing too. So the diagrams of those two chapters will be explained in this video. The first diagram is the structure of a chloroplast. We all know that chloroplast is a structure where the process of photosynthesis occur, and it is the structure which contains chlorophyll, provides a green color to the leaves also. So we are going to see that how to make a chloroplast, and then we'll do the labelings too. Now chloroplast, first of all, it's a double membrane structure, so you have to make double layers, or you can say double membranes. Then it has this fluid filled matrix which has to be you should give a dotted appearance to wherever matrix is. That shows that this space is filled with a semi-fluid or fluid substance. Then there are this circular structures here. You can draw them like this, rounded structures, 2, 3, 4, as many as you want to. Then we have some here also. It's randomly scattered in chloroplast, so you can make it anywhere. Okay? Then, after making this structure, we have to join these. Like, all these structures are joined together with these channels. Okay? After drawing, we'll be labeling these also. So, this is the layout of a chloroplast. Now whenever, keep it in your mind that whenever you are labeling things, try to label them on one side. Okay, try to label them on one side, either on this, I'll prefer the this side of the, you know, the diagram. Now starting off with the labeling, this fluid matrix or this ground substance is known as stroma, stroma. Stroma, now whenever you are labeling, try to label it in caps. Why? Because it gives a clear indication to the examiner that, okay, fine, he knows whatever it is. And in free handwriting, sometimes we miss alphabets. So when you write it like this, it becomes neat and it gives a good impression. Then we have this pile which we had made. This pile consists of 2 to 3 rounded structures. This pile is known as grana. It will be labeled as granum. Okay, now this granum, this whole pile, it has many disc-like structures arranged in it. Now one single disc-like structure is known as a thylakoid. Thylakoid. Okay, and we had made these channels or these lines to join the granum. These are known as fret channels. Fret channels. Okay, now you can clearly see that this is the diagram. I have made all the, I have labeled it on the, on one side with these arrows. Now this is one more important thing. The arrows should always point to the part which you want to present, which you have labeled actually. Then this is the labeling, which is in a proper line and it is written in caps. This is a complete diagram of a chloroplast. This is the way the chloroplast should be presented. This is a 2-marker or a 3-marker diagram, which comes in a 5-marker actually. If you have a question from chapter photosynthesis, there are chances of the examiner to ask you to draw the diagram of the structure which is responsible for the process. That would be chloroplast. Okay, so this is the way we draw a chloroplast. After this, the second diagram which we have in photosynthesis, which is important, and you must know how to draw, and in the same manner in a 5 marker, it can anytime be asked as a 2 marker to be drawn in the paper, or it can come in 1 mark or 2 mark also separately. So that's the structure of a stomata. The second structure which we are going to do is stomata. Now, stomata, we know that these are tiny openings which are present on the surface of the leaf. Now, when we see the structure of stomata, we are going to draw in the same manner. Whenever you are drawing something, please don't draw in the center. Just tilt it to one side of the page so that you have ample of space on this side to label it. Now, when we draw the structure of a stomata, stomata has these guard cells present around the opening. These are kidney shaped. Now, you just slowly make these. Now, always remember, please don't use any of the, you know, accessories to make the diagrams. Draw freehand diagram in biology, because that gives a good, you know, a picture of the diagram. But obviously, it should not be that random or distorted so that it does not look like one. So these are bean shaped structures, the guard cells. Now, guard cells, these are cells, so they ought to have a nucleus in it. How do we make a nucleus? Always remember, we make a nucleus like this. We have to show this nucleolus present in it. It should be darkly, you know, it can be made anywhere, but I'm just making it here in the center so that the examiner clearly knows, okay, fine, he has or she has made the nucleus. Then obviously it's a guard cell, it has chloroplast, many chloroplasts present in it. We'll make chloroplasts like this, dotted appearance. There should be a demarcation between the nucleus and the chloroplast. So this would, you know, give the examiner an idea, okay, fine, the kid knows that chloroplast and nucleus, both of things are present here. Now, there is one more important thing. If you know how to draw this diagram, if suppose it comes for structure as a structural question, you will never ever go wrong in the labeling part, which is very important. Okay, so we have made this. Now, one more important thing, we have mesophyll cells, or you can say the leaf cells, epidermal cells bhi bolte hain, which are present around the stomata, which I think should be made in the diagram also. That gives a, you know, good impression. Then we have to, you know, thicken the inner lining of the guard cell. You can thicken the inner lining, because the inner lining of the guard cell is thick and the outer lining is slightly thin to absorb water. Okay, so now the labeling part, we will label it in the same manner. This epidermal cells, epidermal cells, or in many books it's mesophyll cells also, both are correct. Then we have this dotted part, chloroplast. Then we have this bean shaped structure, guard cell. Then we have this centrally placed, or you can say we have drawn it in the center, the nucleus. Then this lining would be labeled. That's important. This lining, we are just labeling the outer part of the guard cell. That is the outer layer or lining of stomata. Then this thick lining will also be labeled here, inner lining of stomata. Then we have this opening present here. Now, how to label it? Again, we'll make it like this, stoma. Now, many books say that stoma is the plural of stomata. So in order to avoid this confusion, you can label it as stoma or you can label it as stomatal pore. Both will be correct, so they are not wrong. Okay, so this is the way we make a guard cell and label everything properly on one side. Don't miss anything. We have labeled everything. There is nothing which is left out. So obviously the examiner cannot deduct marks at all. One look for the diagram is going to fetch you most full marks. And this question, as already told, if comes as a structural question, you will never go wrong in the labeling part. Okay, so this is all about the diagrams of chapter photosynthesis. There are previous chapters, cell division and genetics. In those, there are diagrams of cell division. I think no one faces problem in drawing those, so I am not taking up those. The next chapter is photosynthesis. We have drawn these two diagrams. Then we have transpiration here and absorption by roots. I'm sorry, but there are no diagrams for drawing in that. In those two chapters, so you need not work on the drawing part of the diagram, because in from those chapters the structural questions they come. That means the diagrams are already drawn and you have to answer. Now in the next video I'll be taking up the diagrams for circulatory system. There are two main important diagrams, the structure of heart and the structure of arteries and veins. Please do watch the video. And obviously share, like, comment, and please do hit the bell icon which is there beneath the video, because whenever I upload the video you'll get a notification and you can see the video and go through it. Okay, thanks a lot.